I get asked these two questions multiple times a day. How can I start in machine learning and how can I follow the news in AI? The first one takes multiple forms, such as how can I start for free, how can I start if I don't have a developer background, or how can I start without any math, etc. So I decided to do this video to answer them once and for all. Of course, since I will share many resources, I also wrote a complete guide on how to start in machine learning in 2021 from no background at all and for free, as well as a GitHub repository with all the useful links. It is linked in the description below. Because of these pertinent questions, I've researched a lot of resources online and I saved the best ones on a notepad over the past 2 years to quickly answer the next upcoming questions. Today I will share this notepad with everyone and list many great resources and give you some of my personal tips on how to learn and improve your machine learning skills and how do I stay up to date with all the news in the field. Oh, and please let me know in the comments if you know any other great resources that I could add to this guide to make this learning process easier and better for everyone. Since this video is a bit special, here are some important timestamps you can skip to if you'd like more information about a specific subject. Otherwise, I will go through this guide and show you how you can develop great machine learning skills without wasting money following your own needs. One last thing. If you are here to know how to stay up to date with the news in the field and learn about the new techniques, you should consider subscribing to my channel since I share exactly this type of content every week. This guide is intended for anyone having zero or a small background in programming, mathematics, or machine learning. This is why I will list resources for all these subjects, but feel free to go at your pace and learn what you want to learn. Also, there is no specific order to follow here. I mainly listed them the way I will do it, but feel free to start with whatever you feel you lack the most. Final little note before sharing these tips with you. It is super important. Do what you wanna do. If you don't like reading books, skip the section. If you don't want to follow an online course, you can skip this one as well. Same thing for videos. There is not a single way to become a machine learning expert, and with motivation, you can absolutely achieve it by creating your own path. Oh, and don't be afraid or ashamed to replay videos or learn the same concepts from multiple sources. Repetition is the key to success in learning something new. Now, let's dive right into it. This section is mainly for complete beginners. In my opinion, the best way to start learning anything is with short videos on YouTube, and this field is no exception. There are thousands of amazing videos and playlists that teach important concepts of machine learning for free on this platform, and you should take advantage of them. Here, I recommend two playlists to watch. They will give you a great first introduction to the terms you need to know to get started in the field. The first one is my own playlist, where I explain the most used terms in the field, which can be very helpful if you are just starting. And then, I'd suggest to dive a little deeper into the foundations of machine learning and deep learning, and learn more about neural networks. Understanding neural networks and backpropagation is the most important thing when starting and gives you an enormous advantage when you dive into more advanced lectures and courses. For this, I will recommend the great playlist made by 3Blue1Brown. Now that you have a good basis of what a machine learning algorithm is, how it works, and how it learns using backpropagation, you are ready to dive even deeper with more complete and advanced courses. This step is a little longer, since you will be watching many hours of free amazing courses on YouTube and learn a lot from them. Please do not watch these courses while doing something else. They are great resources that need concentration, taking notes, and asking questions through online communities, as I will talk later in the video. Here, I share three courses that I followed and loved personally, which are the ones from MIT, Stanford, and Andrew Ng. Again, I just want to remind you that all the links are in the repository linked in the description below, so you don't have to note them down right away. As it has been proven multiple times, humans learn better by repeating and learning in different ways, such as hearing, writing, reading, watching, and etc. This is why it's as important to read as to watch videos for a better understanding. You will cover many angles and have a more complete view of what you are trying to learn. This section is a list of short articles and books that are completely free and optional. If you are into reading, I will suggest starting with these 5 short articles and then jump into the more advanced books. Books are a great way to learn at your rhythm. be sure to understand everything before going into practice mode. The final theoretical subject to cover here is the mathematics behind machine learning, which are extremely important. You can always just apply machine learning algorithms and tweak it until it works, but you will never understand it correctly and improve it following this path. If you have zero background in math, don't worry, just like most things in life, you can learn math. And fortunately for us, there's an awesome website called CAN Academy, where you can learn many mathematics concepts all for free. Here are some great beginner and advanced resources to get into the machine learning math. I also listed some great videos and free books you can check as well. More is better. I will also suggest starting with these three very important concepts in machine learning: linear algebra, probability, and multivariable calculus, which are the three courses I suggested. Of course, if some subjects covered here are already a bit too advanced for you, you can always look to complement these with other courses or books. This section is for beginners in coding. If you have no background at all in Python or any other programming language, this will get you starting and give you an awesome basis for machine learning programming. If you are already pretty familiar with Python, you can skip to the next step. Here, I list the best online courses to learn the programming side of machine learning using Python and have a great background, but you can always decide to learn with another language for sure. Now that you have a good understanding of the theory behind machine learning and a coding background, you are ready to start your way into machine learning courses. Of course, these are all optional. Here, the first one is free and the other ones are paying, since they will teach you many things and some even give you certifications you can use in your resume. If you don't want to follow any courses, you can jump to the next section and start to practice on your own. It will be a little more difficult at first, but with great Googling skills and motivation, you will be able to do this for sure. Otherwise, if you prefer to have clear steps to follow, these courses are the best ones to do, starting from the basics to more advanced from top to bottom. Practice, practice, and practice. The most important thing in programming is practice. And this applies to machine learning too. It can be hard to find a personal project to practice on, but fortunately for us, Kaggle exists. This website is full of free courses, tutorials, and competitions. You can join competitions for free, and just download their data, read about their problem, and start coding and testing right away. You can even earn money from winning competitions, and it is a great thing to have on your resume as well. This may be the best way to get experience while learning a lot, and even earn money. You can also create teams for Kaggle competition and learn with people. I definitely suggest you to join a community to find a team and learn with others. It is always better than learning alone. The following section is devoted to this. Indeed, most of the time, the best way to learn is to learn with someone else. Join online communities and find partners to learn with. This is the reason why I created a Discord server a year ago, with the goal of getting many AI enthusiasts and learn together, ask questions, find Kaggle teammates, share your projects, and much more. It is called Learn AI Together. We are already more than 8,000 people in not even a year. I will be glad to see you there, and please reach out to me if you do. You can also follow Reddit communities, where you can ask questions, share your projects, follow news in the field, and more. Here I list the most popular ones that I follow on a daily basis. Finally, I will recommend you to save cheat sheets on your computer, tablet, or even print them. They are a very good way to compress information and have it all at hand. Here I list the best cheat sheets I could find, and as I just said, even if you are advanced, you should definitely have them printed somewhere near your desk. Now, another important thing in this field is to stay up to date with the new upcoming papers and new applications that are released every single day. A great way is to join LinkedIn and Facebook groups that are sharing these new applications. You can also follow Medium publications and YouTube channels that are summarizing these new papers. Of course, you are already at a pretty good place for this, since I personally do share news related to AI every week. So you should definitely subscribe and turn on the notifications to not miss any future videos. Newsletters are also a great way to have all the news condensed at one place every day or week. Here I list a few of the best ones I know that I personally use in my day-to-day life, but you can surely search for more in your fields of interest. Note that this is a non-exhaustive list of resources. You can definitely use more or less resources and learn at your rhythm. You must follow your instinct to find the best way you can learn. Don't ever feel guilty about replaying a video or reading an article twice to understand a concept. We've all been through this, and it is perfectly normal. The most important thing is that you understand the concept, and not that you go through the list as quickly as possible. Let me know in the comments if you know any other great resources that I could add to this guide to make this learning process easier and better for everyone. Please leave a like if you went this far in the video. And since there are over 80% of you guys that are not subscribed yet, please consider subscribing to the channel to not miss any further news. Thank you for watching.